my esteemed and honorable Vice President Naveen N.D. Guptaji, who is going to be present there, Chairman of the Toronto Chapter Baljeet Kaliravana, past Chairman Manny Gauba, and galaxy of other past Chairman of the Toronto Chapter, representatives from the Consulate and High Commission of India in Canada, CPA Canada and CPA Ontario representatives, my dear members and invitees. I am indeed very happy that the Toronto Chapter of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India is organizing the 11th annual event. Despite my deep desire to be there physically, I am not able to be there physically because of other commitments, but through this message I will be there amongst you with my good wishes. Since inception in 2006, the Toronto Chapter has provided a platform to the members to share and disseminate knowledge amongst themselves, as also it has helped project the image of Institute of Chartered Accountants of India in Canada. The chapter was formed with the view of having a common forum where members could meet, exchange views and interact professionally. It's a very good place to gain knowledge on professional and CPD topics, interact and network. I've been there last year and I know how vibrant and throbbing the chapter is. The chapter, the Toronto chapter, supported new members who come to Toronto to find their bearings. Being an integral part of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, the foreign chapter, and especially Toronto chapter, owe a ubiquitous affiliation to the Institute by carrying such actions that bring an aura to the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India mission of being value to the accountancy profession. In such a context, I am very happy that the foreign chapters of Institute, especially the Toronto chapter, is playing a stellar role and a dynamic role for the members of Institute at Toronto in resolving the issues and for furtherance of the professional pursuits and knowledge. Here I would like to mention that Institute of Chartered Accountants of India is committed to take the Indian Chartered Accountants global and make all efforts to ensure that the mutual recognition of Indian Chartered Accountants with other professional bodies in other countries happen in greater level. Institute of Chartered Accountants of India had signed a Memorandum of Understanding with the Canadian Institute of Chartered Accountants way back in 2011 to enable the respective members at both the ends to take the membership of the other institute. This was intended to provide larger professional avenues to members at respective ends and also provide for the global empowerment. Currently, both the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India and the new merged CPA Canada are working towards heralding a phase of new relationship between the members of the two countries, and the renewal of the Memorandum of Understanding with CPA Canada is under approval at the Government of India level. I am sure that in near future, the two bodies will enter into a framework which will promote firm-to-firm and member-to-member networking. Here, I would like to acknowledge the efforts of past Chairman Manny Gauba and the current Chairman Baljeet Kaliravana in bridging the physical distance between ICAI Delhi and CPA Toronto by interacting and playing a bridge between the two. I would like to acknowledge the efforts of Joy Thomas, President and CEO of CPA Canada, with whom I interact at the IFAC meetings, as also Tashia Batchstone, Vice President of CPA Canada, who have helped a lot in the renewal of the new MOU. Tashia Batchstone recently visited Delhi for her NGO volunteering work, but spared some time for the ICAI Delhi, and we had very fruitful meetings on the way forward on a lot of mutual areas benefiting both the countries. For example, I was informed Canada requires number of skilled manpower in the commercial area as also professional accountants, in of which India has abundance, and we discussed how both the institutions can work together on that. Before I close my address, I would like to state that the efforts of our foreign chapters would be targeted to take further the brand equity of the Indian accountancy profession in this era of globalization, and at the same time excel in their respective domains so as to keep the brand of Indian accountancy profession high. I would wish to request you before I conclude that in India we have a CA Benevolent Fund which takes care of the untimely demise of our CA members to take care of the families. In fact, just to share my experience during my, when I turned 50 a few years back, I didn't celebrate, I just donated whatever I wanted to spend on a party to various institutions which I am connected with, right from my school, college, as also the CA Benevolent Fund. I don't mean that you should not have parties on your momentous occasions, but please take note of the CA Benevolent Fund also and contribute handsomely to the CA Benevolent Fund. Another area I want you to take attention to is to take care of your health. Ours is a very sedentary job, and physical fitness is of prime importance because this is what keeps us running. I wish that you focus on that particular area of health also tremendously. Wishing the chapter many more glorious years of service to the profession and also to the two countries as it reaches new milestones of silver jubilees and golden jubilees. All the very best to the chapter and to our members there. Thank you. Jai Hind.